Hi everyone, so I know I've been posting a lot of in utero themed videos recently. It's kind of because I've been really chasing and trying to get a similar sound. I know I'm not going to get it exact because I just don't physically have the equipment and the physical space in terms of like a studio to actually be able to crank the amp and stuff. But today I'm going to give you guys a quick guide on how to get a similar sort of sound but at bedroom level. So I'm going to be doing a few things that maybe you hadn't thought of or you could try yourself, so hopefully this video helps a few of you. I'd like to give big thanks to Aaron Rash regarding a few things in this video, so yeah, a big shout out to him, and I'll have his channel linked in the description. So I'm gonna go in order here, the guitar and then down through the pedal chain and just to the amp. So I'll start here with the guitar. It's actually behind me and it is my MJT Jaguar. This is it here. If you want to see the full specs of this guitar, you can go watch my video on the channel regarding this guitar. But yeah, pretty much I use this guitar for the majority of in utero stuff that I'm doing, and that's just simply because I think it sounds the closest. It's very bright and it has that very sort of ringy loose sound to it, which I think really sort of gets quite close to the sound. One thing you're going to want to do with a bright guitar like this is to back the tone knob off a bit. So I back mine off about a quarter or so. It really depends. You can sort of switch it about for each song if you want to really sort of, if you want to go into like fine tweaking, but I usually leave it at about a quarter rolled off, or sometimes I just leave it at full depending on how bright or dark I want the sound. So that's the first thing I would consider doing, is having a play about with the tone control on your guitar, because a lot of people tend to just leave it at 10 and forget about it. So yeah, it's just an extra option you have in terms of shaping the sound. So from the Jaguar, I was going out into this pedal here, a SansAmp original pedal. This isn't the classic, this is like the original unit, but it sounds like identical to the classic. I actually have a classic as well as this one, and yeah, they sound pretty much the same, so it doesn't matter. If you don't have one of these pedals, you can use something like a SansAmp GT2, and I know there's a few clones of the pedal, a few cheap clones, I forget the names of them, but yeah, there's a few cheap clones of this pedal about, and you should be able to get a similar sound with it. So the settings here are from Aaron Rash's video on the distorted tones of in utero, and I've pretty much copied those exactly, bar the high control, which I've just set to full because you kind of need to put it up when you've got the tone control lowered on your guitar, just to bring back some of the lost high frequencies. So yeah, that's sort of the next step. I'll leave that on the screen for a second if you want to get the settings. Next here, I'm gonna go over the amp and microphone situation. So I'm using my Silverface Twin, and I'll show you the settings here. So volume I have set to just over 4, and this gives a bit of a breakup sound. These Silverface Fenders have quite a fuzzy overdrive sound, so I sort of set the volume so it just starts to break up when you really hit the low notes quite hard. For the EQ, here you can see I have the treble on 5, middle on 10, and bass on 5. You really want to set this treble control around 5 just to really roll off that high end. If you listen to a lot of the clean tracks on In Utero Isolated, you can hear that they're quite flat sounding and that they've got a lot of mid-range and bass, but the treble is definitely rolled off quite a bit. So you want to make sure the treble in your amp is set about halfway or so. The middle I just crank all the way up because I think that's what sounds the best, and it tends to give this fuzzy quality to the tone, which sounds pretty cool. So I think cranking the mids on this amp in particular sounds the best. And then the bass is just on 5. I find that putting the bass up higher than that sort of makes the low end a bit flubby, and then below that it sort of thins out the sound too much. So I think 5 is quite a balanced setting for this amp in particular. And then the master can just be set to whatever level you want.
So
So for the microphone, I'm using a Rode Anti-1A, and this is a cheap condenser mic. I'm just placing it about 10 inches from the cabinet, and I'm placing it in between the speakers. So placing the mic here in between the speakers has a bit of a weird effect where it creates this like filter matrix type sound that you kind of hear on a lot of the In Utero recordings. So I think if you've only got one microphone, this is a cool spot to try and experiment with. I've been experimenting with mic positioning quite a lot recently, and this has been my sort of preferred go-to spot for the mic. So yeah, I definitely recommend playing about with that. It really does have a huge impact on the sound. So after we come out of the mic, I'm going into an Audient Evo 4 interface, and this is plugged directly into my PC. From there, I'm going into Audacity, and I'm just recording in mono since I have, I'm just using one mic for this. But yeah, you can see my tracks here that I've done. So I'm going to switch over to the video of me playing along with the track, and you can judge for yourself how you think this sounds. But yeah, I hope you enjoy.